Good morning. This is Kelloland on the go with all you need to know in news and weather as you start your day.
We expect to learn more information today about a murder in Wessington Springs. The investigation started Sunday morning when officers were called to a home for a reported hostage situation and deadly shooting. The DCI says one person was allowed to leave the home before the suspect, Mitch Caffey, surrendered.
Meanwhile, the Girald County State's Attorney has confirmed to Kelloland News there was a single-victim homicide Sunday morning. The DCI says Caffey was arrested on charges of murder, kidnapping, and more. And we are learning more about Rapid City's latest homicide. Investigators believe a group of people witnessed last week's stabbing, and some of those people shot videos of what led up to the crime. The victim, 24-year-old Leon Richards, later died of his injuries.
If you or someone you know witnessed someone stabbing him or have video of the crime, police want to talk to you. You can either call police or text RCPD and the information to 847-411. Kelloland Investigates exposed the issue of the lack of public notification of specific parole hearings last month.
That's what happened in the notorious case of Deborah Jenner, whose parole hearing went undetected until Kelloland Investigates began looking into it.
Now another violent criminal was up for parole this month, but we were blocked from a teleconference of Levi Flute's hearing, which wasn't even on the board's posted agenda.
Plus, his victim had no idea it was happening.
I would want to know, has he been working on himself? Did he get on his knees and say, I'm sorry for this? Has he repented?
Coming up tonight, Angela Kennecke brings you Don Ospa's horrific story. In 1989, Levi Flute and David Arapaho broke into her home and held her young daughter at knife point while she was raped and beaten.
How victims are left in the dark when it comes to what's happening with their offenders, despite Marcy's Law. Tonight on Kelloland News at 10.
A round of rain is on its way to parts of Kelloland. Let's find out when with meteorologist Scott Munt. Scott?
All right, good morning, everybody. We are watching rain for today across western South Dakota, and it will eventually move west to east as we get into tonight and tomorrow. Even a chance at a couple of thunderstorms and locally heavy rainfall. Windy in the meantime for today. Strong southerly winds in central and eastern Kelloland. Wind gusts over 40 miles per hour looking likely. And I mentioned that rain chance coming through. And then we are looking at cooler temperatures just in time for Halloween. More details on the Kelloland Live Doppler forecast with Brian, coming up.
Thank you, Scott. Speaking of which, kids in their costumes out trick-or-treating is a familiar sight on Halloween. However, it's important to make sure you are taking extra precautions while driving through neighborhoods.
The city of Sioux Falls doesn't see a lot of issues with kids running in the streets, but it's still important to watch the road extra close, as well as remind your children to stay safe.
We really don't have a lot of problems, thankfully, on Halloween, but make sure kids are crossing from corner to corner. They're not running in the middle of the street. Motorists need to be aware and drive extra slow, just because kids don't always pay attention to that sort of stuff.
It is also recommended that kids dress in light colors or wear reflective items. Silver Star is set to offer a car wash with a scare for a cause.
Silver Star is hosting its third annual Haunted Car Wash starting tomorrow night, with a portion of the proceeds benefiting Feeding South Dakota.
Every dollar that goes to Feeding South Dakota feeds three families. So my personal goal would be 20,000 families being fed this year through our donations or through the community's donations.
We can't do what we do without the support of our community partners like Silver Star. Our volunteers and our community supporters is how we're able to reach all of the different patrons that we're able to reach across Sioux Falls.
This year's theme is Carnival of Screams. The Haunted Car Wash is available from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. tomorrow through Saturday at the 57th and Marion location only. We've received even more pictures from viewers of their Halloween preparations. Tracy sent us these pictures of the family carving pumpkins as well as the finished products. And they also got a preview of some of the kids' Halloween costumes for the upcoming day.
If you have a picture of your spooky costumes and decorations, we'd love to see them. Just send them to youshare at kelloland.com and they may be featured online or even on air. Let's look at some of our top stories.
Now let's get one last look at your weather with meteorologist Brian Karstens. Brian?
All right, weather today, looking at a dry day today, but then the rain is coming. Let's have a look at the latest footprint on the rain map, if you will, and you can see clearly eastern South Dakota into western Minnesota, northwest Iowa. Maybe that 1-inch number, is that achievable? I think it's in the ballpark here, and that's basically communities east of the James Valley. We'll continue to monitor the latest trends throughout the day. Embedded thunder tonight could make the difference, pushing some of the local totals closer to that 1.5-inch mark or higher. You'll notice western and central South Dakota, some rain on the way the next 24 hours, but amounts are generally under 1/4 inch. So that's kind of our takeaway as we bring into view now futurecast. So during the day today, a stiff southeast wind, 20 to 40. We'll monitor temperatures in the middle and upper 50s ahead of the front. Here comes the rain snow band in the west. There is snow with this in the Black Hills, but it's not to the level of worthiness of an advisory. But it does appear those showers and thunderstorms sparking east tonight, pretty common. And tomorrow, we're also going to incorporate additional bands of rain moving up from the south. So plan accordingly here for rainy weather on Wednesday. Then we're into northwest winds after that. And it looks like right now, mid and upper 40s, pretty likely there to start off Thursday. All right, highs today, we're back into the upper 50s in Sioux Falls, mid-50s Aberdeen, mid and upper 50s Pierre. Here's your 7-day forecast, and I think right now, middle and upper 50s, pretty common here. As we wrap up the week, we're looking at 48 on Sunday, 43 on Monday, getting a little colder. The forecast for Aberdeen also looks plenty chilly here Sunday to Monday as we drop into the 40s. So getting set for that bigger change in the weather. The chance of rain again is noted pretty good tomorrow. Also a good chance of showers in Pierre. High temperature 61 and 60s there returning on Friday. We also think that Rapid City will have a nice bounce on the temperature going into the weekend. It's coming out on the backside where it's a little colder. Maybe 30s or highs early next week. Keep watching for those changes. Find out more coverage online at KetherLand.com and have yourself a great Tuesday.